Good afternoon, children. Today let me learn cyclic structure of glucose. Last class we studied structure of glucose. Very important question. Today let me learn cyclic structure of glucose. Fischer identified that the open chain pentahydroxylaldehyde structure of glucose. Okay. Fischer identified open chain pentahydroxyl. So this structure is a open chain structure. That one is a closed structure. Okay. Unlike simple aldehyde, glucose did not form crystalline bisulfite. Glucose doesn't form crystalline bisulfite compound with the sodium bisulfite. Glucose does not give Chips test and pentacetate derivative of glucose. Glucose was not oxidized by Tollens reagent or Fehling solution. So these behaviors could not be explained by the open chain structure. Okay. So Fischer identified open chain pentahydroxylaldehyde structure of glucose. Fischer identified open chain. That compound is a open chain. Pentahydroxylaldehyde. Pentahydroxyl means here how many OH is there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So, pentahydroxylaldehyde group. That he proposed did not completely explain its chemical behavior. That is, unlike simple aldehyde, glucose did not form crystalline bisulfate compound with the sodium bisulfate. It does not form bisulfite compound. Then glucose does not give Chips test. It does not give pentacetate derivative. Then glucose was not oxidized by Tollens or Fehling solution. This behavior could not be explained by the open chain structure. In addition, glucose is found to crystallize in two different forms depending on crystallization condition with a different melting point. Okay, during the crystallization, it have the melting point 499 to 423 Kelvin. Glucose, one of the hydroxyl group, react with the aldehyde group to form cyclic structure. Okay. So glucose, one of the hydroxyl groups, react with the aldehyde group to form a cyclic structure, that is hemiacetal form. Okay. So this is a cyclic structure. So, the conversion of the achiral aldehyde carbon into chiral one leading to the possibility of two isomers. That two isomers differ only in configuration of C1 carbon atom. These isomers are called anomers. What is meant by anomers? The isomer differ only in the configuration of C1 carbon atom. Configuration of C1 carbon atom. Okay. So that is called anomers. The two anomeric forms of glucose are called alpha glucose and beta glucose. Two anomeric form of glucose is alpha glucose, beta glucose. What is meant by anomers? The two isomers. These two isomers only differ in the configuration of C1 carbon atom. The two anomeric forms of glucose are called alpha and beta forms. The cyclic structure of glucose is similar to pyran. A cyclic compound with 5 carbon and 1 oxygen atom. Okay, here 5 carbon and 1 oxygen atom. I can see is called pyranose form. Okay, so this form also known as pyranose form. The specific rotation of alpha and beta to glucose are 112 degree and 18.7 degree. Okay, specific rotation of glucose, alpha glucose and beta D glucose is 112 and 18.7 degree. Sugar is dissolved in water. Slow interconversion of alpha D glucose and beta D glucose via open chain form occurs until equilibrium is established, giving a constant specific rotation plus 53 degree. This phenomenon is called muta rotation. So what is meant by muta rotation? Okay, so when a pure form of any one of the sugar is dissolved in water, slow interconversion of alpha D glucose and beta D glucose via open chain form occurs until equilibrium is established, giving constant specific rotation plus 53 degree. This phenomenon is called muta rotation. Next, let me learn epimers and epimerization. So what is meant by epimers? Or what is meant by epimerization? Sugar differing in configuration at an asymmetric center is known as epimers. Sugar differentiating in configuration at an asymmetric center is known as epimers. Okay, so asymmetric center. See the first carbon, second carbon. This carbon surrounded by here top CH aldehyde, OH, H. The next CH, OH, COH, H. CH2OH, OH, H. Okay. So here this first carbon is asymmetric carbon. That means this carbon linked with four different types of groups. This is one of the group. Another hydrogen. Third group hydroxyl. Fourth group CHO. Okay. So that carbon is asymmetric carbon center. That is called epimers. The process by which one epimer is converted into other epimer is called epimerization. So that conversion, one epimer converted into another epimer, it requires the enzyme epimers. Galactose is converted into glucose by this manner in our body. Next, let me learn structure of fructose. Another important question is structure of fructose. Okay, first let me learn how to prepare the fructose. Fructose is another commonly known monosaccharide. That fructose having the same molecular formula as glucose, it is levorotatory and heterohexose. Only two different. Glucose is a dextrorotatory, but fructose is a levorotatory. Glucose is a aldose. Fructose is a ketohexose. Okay. So it is present abundantly in fruits and hence it is called a fruit sugar. So fructose present in fruits. So it is also called fruit sugar. The next, let me learn preparation of fructose. How to prepare fructose? Fructose prepared from sucrose. Sucrose means cane sugar. Okay. So fructose is obtained from sucrose by heating with the dilute sulfuric acid or with the enzyme inverters. Okay. Sucrose formula C12H12. H22O11. Okay, so it is hydrolyzed, addition of water in presence of acid or inverters. Enzyme is a inverters to form glucose and fructose. Fructose is separated by crystallization. The mixture having equal amount of glucose and fructose is termed as invert sugar. Okay, so what is meant by invert sugar? The mixture having equal amount of glucose and fructose, that is called invert sugar. Next, how to prepare glucose from inulin? Fructose is prepared commercially by hydrolysis of inulin. Inulin means polysaccharide in an acidic medium. So inulin means n times C6 H12O5 plus hydrolyzed number of molecules, okay, to form fructose. Next, let we learn structure of fructose. Fructose is the sweetest of all known sugars. Fructose is readily soluble in water. Fresh solution of fructose has a specific rotation, that is specific rotation value is minus 133 degree, which changes to 92 degree equilibrium due to mutual rotation similar to glucose. The fructose deduced from following facts. Okay, so the structure of fructose, first point, elemental analysis and molecular weight determination of fructose. Okay, molecular formula of fructose is C6H12O6. That is first point. The molecular formula of fructose is C6H12O6. Second point, fructose on reduction with hydrogen iodide and red phosphorus gives a mixture of N-hexane. Okay, so the reactant is fructose and hydrogen iodide or phosphorus on reduction to form N-hexane. So this reaction indicates 6 carbon atom in fructose in a straight line. See, a fructose reacted with hydrogen or iodine in presence of fructose is reduction by hydrogen iodide or phosphorus to form N-hexane. Fructose reacted with ammonium hydroxide and hydrogen cyanide, it shows the presence of carbonyl groups in the fructose. Okay, fructose react with ammonium hydroxide and hydrogen cyanide, it shows the presence of a carbonyl group in the fructose. Fructose reacted with acetic anhydride in presence of pyridine to form pentacetate. Okay, fructose react with acetic anhydride in presence of pyridine, so to form pentacetate. This reaction indicate the presence of 5 hydroxyl group in a fructose molecule. So fructose is not oxidized by bromine water. This rules out of the possibility presence of an aldehyde group. Okay, so fructose is not oxidized by bromine water. This rules out the possibility of pressure and presence of an aldehyde group. Okay, so partial reduction of fructose with the sodium amalgam and water produce mixture of sorbitol and mannitol. Okay, so the fructose partial reduction of with the sodium amalgam and water produce mixture of sorbitol and mannitol, which are epimers. Epimers in the second carbon. New asymmetric carbon is formed at C2. This confirms in the presence of heto group. See the structure of fructose. Fructose having the functional group is C double bond O. Okay, it is reduction with sodium amalgam to form sorbitol and mannitol. Okay, so the sorbitol and mannitol same structure, but only one different. The second carbon OH is right side is sorbitol. Second carbon OH left side is mannitol. On oxidation with nitric acid, it gives glycolic acid and tartaric acid. Okay, oxidation with nitric acid to give glycolic acid and tartaric acid, which contains small number of carbon atom in the fructose. See the structure. Fructose is oxidized in presence of concentrated nitric acid to form glycolic acid, COOH, CH2O, glycolic acid and tartaric acid. Okay, so this shows that a keto group present in carbon 2, that means second carbon having the keto group. It also shows that primary alcoholic group are present at C1 and C6. Based on evidence, the following structure of fructose. So this is the structure of fructose. Second carbon having functional group, sixth carbon alcohol group, CH2OH. Next, let me learn cyclic structure of fructose. Like glucose, fructose also forms cyclic structure. Unlike glucose, it forms five-membered ring that is similar to furan. Okay, so furan means in between O. So, hence that structure is called furanose. So, that look fructose closed structure is look like a furan. So, that compound name prunose. When fructose is a component of a saccharide as in sucrose, it is usually occur in furanose form. Okay. So, see here alpha D. Fructose, beta D fructose. Okay, beta D alpha D, this only one group changed. Two more question. They will ask structure of, draw the structure of fructose, draw the structure of glucose, then alpha D glucose, beta D glucose. So that is structure, write and study.